Hello, my name is Dr. Rihanna Rogers, and I'm an assistant professor of cultural studies at State University of New York's Empire State College. The current presentation that you are about to hear is entitled New Directions in Maya Research, Using History and Anthropology to Study the Mayan Site of Toh Mérida, Yucatan. This presentation is part of the 9th International Conference on New Directions in Humanities at the Universidad de Granada, and is part of the First Nations and Indigenous Peoples stream. In order to understand the interdisciplinary nature of this project, it's first important to locate the site of this actual project within a geographic structure. The site of Toh Mérida is located within the northeastern corner of the Yucatan Peninsula, in what is considered the northern Mayan lowlands. Archaeologists and historians have been studying this region since the time that the Spanish contacted the Maya beginning in the 1500s. However, extensive archaeological research has been highlighted within the last 100 to 150 years. Keeping geography in mind, this paper will present the results of the Ciudadela Artifact Analysis, a historical and archaeological study dealing with the assemblage originally collected from Tihu Mérida in 1956 and 57 by Dr. John Goggin and currently housed at the University of Florida, Florida Museum of Natural History. As one of the only stratigraphic samples excavated from the mine site of Toh, now destroyed and buried beneath the Yucatan capital city, Mérida, the Ciudadela collection represents a rare glimpse into a significant, yet understudied, Type I archaeological site. For the purpose of my project, I created the following research question. How did the pre-Columbian and historical exchange impact Mayan material culture at the site of Tihu Mérida, Yucatan? In order to determine the research question's validity, I created three main objectives, the first being to construct a localized chronology for the Ciudadela artifact assemblage, two, to comment on the site function for each cultural occupation represented at this site, both historically and archaeologically, and three, to determine what, if any, changes occurred to the production of material culture in pre- and post-Spanish contact periods. Unlike other locations in the Yucatan Peninsula, where archaeological sites still persist and are located in regions, because of the discretion of Tihu Mérida in recent years, most of the information from this site comes from the historical narratives created by both the Spaniards and the pre-Columbian and colonial Maya. The Relaciones Historiográficas de Gobernación de Yucatán mention that the Yucatan Peninsula was first reported to the crown in 1517 by Hernández Córdoba, explored by Juan de Grijalva in 1518, and traversed by Hernán Cortés in 1519. Diego de Landa's Relación de las Cosas de Yucatán and Pietro Anguera's The Decades of the New World or West Indies provide detailed descriptions of the royal orders given to the crown to Francisco de Montejo I in 1526, which instructed him to colonize the Yucatán and found its capital city, Mérida. 2 decades later, Landa and Martín de Palomar reported to the crown and the political and social makeup of Mérida, which at that time would have still been referred to as Toh. This was reported together in a document created in 1580 called the Documentos Inéditos de Otromar. Written 100 years later, Diego López de Coyudos, Historia de Yucatán, summarized the founding and planning of the city of Mérida, including the Ciudadela complex used in this interdisciplinary study of this presentation. Although all these works have contributed to understanding the Maya, the foundations for historical understanding of the post-contact Maya primarily comes from the works of Bishop Landa. The irony lies in the fact that in addition to his contributions to my understanding, Landa is primarily credited with the destruction of roughly 90% of all of Mayan codices and pre-Columbian texts, which has left us in the predicament we are with relying on the historical narrative for understanding the pre-Columbian site and the colonial and modern site of Mérida. As previously highlighted, Toh is an archaeological site located underneath what is today the modern Mexican municipality of Mérida, which is also the modern capital of the state of Yucatan. Tihu Mérida is part of the northern Yucatan Peninsula in what archaeologists refer to as the northern Mayan lowlands. It is considered a multi-component site, meaning that it was occupied from the pre-Columbian era through to the modern era. Toh is listed in the Atlas Arqueológico de Estado de Yucatan as a Type 1 site, which is the highest classifications for sites in the entire Yucatan Peninsula. Beginning in the 1940s and 50s, E.H. Thompson was the first to write archaeological works about this site. Tho conducted surface collections and documented both colonial and pre-Columbian structures in and around the site of Tho. During his survey, Tho collected 12 pre-Columbian potsherds from a site he named Mound near Mérida. In the mid-1950s, George W. Brainer returned to the site in order to relocate the mound structure Thompson had documented and to take additional surface collections. However, Brainer's attempt to relocate Thompson's mound were unsuccessful. Nonetheless, Brainer stated in his text, The Archaeological Ceramics of the Yucatan, published in 1958, that he was able to re-examine Thompson's 12 sherds stored at the Peabody Museum at Harvard and determine their cultural affiliations. Brainer concluded that these pots represented ceramics from what is today classified as the early Nabache and Acibil ceramic phases, which are correlated temporally as AD 300 to about AD 600, and the Sotuta Horizon phase, which is associated with AD 600 to about AD 1000, respectively. Based on these classifications, Brainer determined that Tho was a site occupied since the late formative, or what is today called the late preclassic period. In the mid-1950s, Edward Shook and Tatiana Proskoryakov returned to Mérida and excavated structures in Tho under the guidance of the Carnegie Institute. Shook and Proskoryakov were the first to formally document the Ciudadela structure during the 1951 and 1956 field seasons. Unfortunately, their artifact yield was minimal, and thus the Ciudadela component of the project was abandoned. During the summer of 1956, Goggin conducted a pedestrian survey of the Ciudadela complex as part of the Carnegie Institute's Survey of Mayan and Colonial Sites. During this project, which mostly concentrated on documenting pre-Columbian and colonial structures throughout the city of Mérida, Goggin and his team collected 67 Maiolica sherds from, quote, various levels along the face of the Ciudadela platform remnant, of which the results were originally published in his now famous text, Spanish Maiolica and the New World. Based on his surface findings and interest in historical Maiolica, Goggin returned to the Ciudadela structure in 1957, sponsored by the Carnegie Institute and the University of Florida, to excavate a 1.5 meter by 6.1 meter, which correlates to 5 feet by 20 feet, trench along the remaining outer edge of the Ciudadela structure. It is important to note that at the time of Goggin's survey and later excavation, the only remaining portion of the once two-square block Ciudadela platform was a 3.7 meter by 4.6 meter, which constitutes 12 feet by 15 feet, section comprised of what was most likely the northernmost edge of the structure. Goggin noted that the majority of the structure had been removed for land development and road construction for the creation of the San Benito Marketplace, which still thrives today. Since the 1960s, archaeological research at Tho, and now colonial and modern Mérida, has been the result of salvage archaeological projects conducted by the city of Mérida and the Instituto Nacional de Antropología y Historia, or the National Institute of Anthropology and History. I have used the results of these research findings from both the United States, Europe, as well as Mexico to work on this project.